The Philippine Labor Chief is confident the government will be able to sustain the improving labor market. Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma says the government intends to do so with the help of the private sector. But he also admits generating quality jobs remains to be a challenge.
Yung pong quality jobs ang talagang hinahanap natin. And hopefully, with the pledges and commitments po ng mga foreign investors kay Presidente, ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos Jr., sana po magkaroon na ito ng realisasyon. We also hope that yung mga pledges na mayroon pong mga promises ng number of jobs, specifically ang na-compute ng number dyan, more than 200,000, which eventually would be translated into more.
The Trade and Industry Department, meanwhile, vows to continue attracting investments that produce higher quality and higher paying jobs. The agency asserts the benefits of President Marcos Jr.'s business meetings abroad are already taking effect in some industries.
Meron na po tayong nakita na or inani doon sa investment pledges na yon na mga 20 projects. We have identified 20 projects na ito po ay tinatawag nating green-lighted na. And mostly, nandito po sila sa sectors ng manufacturing, IT BPM, renewable energy, data centers, and telecoms.
The Philippines' jobless rate falls to a record low in November thanks to strong employment from the transport and agriculture sectors. Andrea Taguines with the details.
The unemployment rate in the country eased to a new record low of 3.6% in November. This translates to 1.83 million jobless Filipinos, down from October's over 2 million unemployed. The employment rate also hit a high of 96.4%. According to the Philippine Statistics Authority, the high passenger demand led to the creation of over 100,000 jobs in the transportation sector alone.
Particularly yung related sa mga tourism industry, no, yung sa mga pag-hire ng mga buses, tour operators, and the like.
Rent-a-van driver Reynaldo Tejada said he even got paid more than double his usual earnings due to the travel rush.
Mga balikbayan, yun, nagpapati sa probinsya. Marami din kaming kliyente ng Ondas. Talagang di namin alam talaga sino yung aming sisirban.
The agriculture sector, meanwhile, also contributed significantly to the newly generated jobs. An economist attributed this to adjustments in the harvest season as the government tried to address food supply issues to temper inflation. But because of the seasonality of some jobs, the underemployment rate for November remained steady at 11.7%. That means many Filipinos are still looking for better quality jobs or additional work hours to earn more, just like Tejada.
Tong January, wala na, mahina na. Back to normal talaga eh. Kaya bahala ko nga sana mag-extra-extra uli sa taxi.
That's typical. Tumaas yung number of employed and not all of them could be absorbed in terms of the full employment.
The National Economic and Development Authority also underscored the need for alternative work arrangements, even in the formal economy, to allow more youth and women to work despite their academic and family obligations. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Meanwhile, most Asian markets staged a rebound after days of losses. Japan's Nikkei 225 hit a 33-year high, boosted by tech stocks. Australia's ASX 200, meanwhile, got a boost from data showing November retail sales posted the biggest monthly gain in 2 years. The South Korean KOSPI index, on the other hand, got a drag from heavyweight Samsung Electronics. That's after the tech giant flagged a possible 35% drop in fourth quarter operating profit, citing persistent weak consumer demand. Samsung shares slumped 2.3% following the news. Now here at home, the local bourse got a boost from strong employment numbers. The main index rose by a tenth of a percent to settle at 66.18.
We've seen bouts of profit-taking, and I think it's understandable. Maybe they are going to re-enter market again at 6,500, 6,550, when and if the disappointment in the economic data comes out. But so far, the pronouncements from the central bank and from China have been very supportive. Secretary joked na like 100 basis point cut in interest rate and in China reduced bank reserves. So the market loves additional liquidity and we're having all the positive news flow. So far, 6,600 maybe could hold.
And here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Hewlett-Packard and Juniper Networks. That's after the Wall Street Journal reported the tech company is close to acquiring Juniper for approximately $13 billion. Hewlett-Packard shares plunged 10%, while Juniper Networks shares skyrocketed over 22%. Also in focus, shares of Volkswagen, which saw its sales recover in 2023 after experiencing supply chain troubles. Shares of the car maker, though, fell 1%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of GSK as it acquires biotech firm Aiolos Bio in a bid to enhance its respiratory disease treatment portfolio. GSK shares are up 1%. We're also keeping an eye on shares of Spanish drug maker Grifols after hedge fund Gotham City Research alleged its debt ratios are roughly double those officially reported. The stock last traded lower by 26% after it plunged by as much as 40% in early trade.
Philippine Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno sees an aggressive policy easing from the central bank this year. He told Bloomberg TV on Tuesday the Banco Central could match the expected rate cuts of the Fed and could lower rates by as much as 100 basis points. The former central bank governor sits as a member of the BSP's monetary board as finance secretary. His remarks came after the BSP said its borrowing rates will remain sufficiently tight in the near term, with inflation risks still leaning on the upside. It also followed the release of the December inflation print, which showed the measure of consumer prices declining to a 22-month low of 3.9%. The policy tightening of Manila's monetary authority has been one of the most aggressive in Southeast Asia. It has hiked its rates by 450 basis points since 2022 in its fight against inflation.